you don't release your emotions by acting upon an emotion that's unloving. You release your emotions by connecting to the underlying emotional reason why you want to do that particular thing.
But yeah, but if you have a negative intention or evil thought, then that means you have, in a way, committed murder up in your mind.
That's correct.
Or torture up in your mind.
That's correct.
And
you need to release the emotional reason why you've had that thought.
Okay.
And if you want to come to God.
Yeah. And how do you release it?
By connecting to the underlying emotion. And the underlying emotion might be that you've been harmed a lot by other people, mm-hmm. and or that you feel terrible about yourself. It could be, there could be literally, with regard to a murder, there literally could be hundreds of different types of emotions that causes a person to murder. The key is to not act in harmony with an unloving thing. Remember I said we must also act in harmony with love. So we don't act in harmony with an unloving desire, but what we do is we feel the emotion of the unloving desire fully. So I would go out to my boxing bag and get a baseball bat and yell and scream and swear and bash and just connect to the emotion. And after I do that, drop down into the grief. And when do I drop down into the grief of that? Then I'll be crying about whatever it is that caused me to be so upset about that particular person. Just, I want to ask, Mary wants to answer a few things about it too.
Yeah, I think it's a really valid question because I think if somebody's new, that they don't quite understand the difference between a causal emotion and an effect emotion.
Yeah.
And definitely when someone wants to murder or torture or harm another, they're already acting in an avoidance of some of their own personal pain.
They're really denying their own personal pain.
So there's a common assumption on the earth that some people are just murderous and some people are just evil, if you like. But my belief is that that's not the case. Those people are really trying to avoid a deeper causal emotion within them. And all anger is actually an avoidance of those kind of emotions, yeah.
So all anger and rage is an avoidance technique. Not you're not actually dealing with your emotions when you're in that state.
Right. The thing is now, this may sound a bit off, but you have some people who believe that the reason why some murderer or serial killer, rapist, the reason why they can't control themselves is because they have a dark, twisted, like, you know, satanic or demonic entity within them.
That is true.
Yeah.
But can I just explain? A spirit who is a dark spirit, an entity who's dark, may connect to us, but if we deal with our causal emotion, that spirit cannot cause us to murder.
And in order for a person to do that, he need the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit of Lord Jesus Christ moving within them. Like,
well, the truth is that we don't need it. The truth is we can deal with our emotions without God, but it is much harder to deal with our emotions without God. And so this is why on the divine love path, when you're connecting to God, you realize you've got to deal with your emotions that are murderous or angry and rageful and all those emotions, but you actually get to the underlying emotion, and the way you do it is always feeling your connection with God. And as you do that, what happens is you sink down into the underlying emotion instead of trying to express the denial emotion. The denial emotion is always things like rage, anger, abusing others, hurting others, even yelling at others, is all not on the divine love path. When you're doing all of those things, you are now out of harmony with God, and you're now denying emotions within yourself.